Hello students, I am just standing before you to deliver the lecture number 5 of class 8 mathematics. In the lecture number 4 I have finished up to the exercise 3.1 and a few sums I have solved on the blackboard. Now I am going to explain the exercise number 3 in which there are few sums, only 6 sums are there. So I would also like to include some sums from the examples. Examples number 1 here is given that to cover this. A quadrilateral is given that. A quadrilateral is in this way. A quadrilateral here forming the 90 degree. This is a 90 degree and this is a 50 degree. 50 degree and this one is a exterior angle is given that 110 degree and this is a x degree. Now you have to find the value of x, this degree, exterior angle of this. Here I already have explained the theory, lots of the theory I have, numbers of the theory I have explained on the blackboard in the different lectures, and now I am going to explain the exercise 3.2. after the explaining the 3.1, the exercise number is 3.2, and this is from the example sum A, B and C, and it is D. Since you already know that if a line is standing on the other line and one angle is a 90 degree, then obviously absolutely you can say that this angle will be also the 90 degree. And since it is a 90 degree, first we have to find this angle, this will be the 90 degree. And this is the 50 degree, and obeying the rule of the linear pairs, and already I have explained that if a line extending on the other lines, then sum of this angle equal to 180 degree. Since this line is extending on this line, therefore this is 50 degree, therefore this will be the 130 degree. And again this is also a line lying on this line, if this is a 110 degree, therefore this will be the 70 degree. And now you can use the angle sum property, angle A, since we know that angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D equal to 180 degree. Angle here is a 90 degree, this is a 130 degree, and this is a 70 degree, therefore you can find the angle D, 360 degree, and this will be the 360 degree. And now you can combine this 70 plus 30, 200, 290 degree. This will be the 290 degree plus angle D equal to 360 degree. And angle D equal to 360 degree minus 290 degree. Therefore, angle D equal to means 70 degree. Therefore, this will be the 70 degree. Now, using the linear pair method, 70 degree plus this degree equal to 180 degree. Therefore, this will be the 110 degree. Therefore, angle X plus 70 degree equal to 180 degree, or X degree equal to 180 degree minus 70 degree equal to 110 degree. Next sum I will also take from the example, that is given that the find the number of the side of the regular polygon whose each exterior angle has measure 45 degree.
here.
Find two number. Example two, find the number of side. Find the number of sides. If exterior angle, if each exterior angle measure 45 degree. I have given that a formula in the lecture number 4, that then each exterior angle here, exterior angle is given that, and total number of side, the total number of side, number of sides equal to 360 by exterior angles. If you will divide 360 by 45, then that gives the number of the side. And 3 to 8 times, this will be the 8. The number of side is 8. Number of sides equal to 8 means octagon means the polygon is a octagon, means made of the 8 sides. Next, some next sum is that from the exercise 3.2. here a triangle is given that, and each side is produced such that forming the exterior angle 125 degree, and this side is also produced and its value is 125 degree, and this is the x degree, and you have to find the value of x. And already you know that the linear pair methods, if this angle is 125 degree, this angle plus this angle makes together 180 degree, A, B and C. This angle plus this angle equal to 125. Therefore, angle A will be 180 degree minus 125. Therefore, 5 and 7 minus 2, 55 degree. And angle B, similarly angle B equal to 180 degree minus 125 also. 125, this is also 125, therefore this will be again 55 degree. Angle C, now the term of the angle C, how you will find that angle C? So we will use here angle sum property, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degree. Angle A is a 55 degree, angle B is also 55 degree, and angle C equal to 180 degree. 110 degree plus angle C equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle C equal to 180 degree minus 110 degree. Therefore, this will be the 70 degree. Therefore, interior angle of this is a 70 degree, and again you will use the linear pair 70 degree plus x degree equal to 180 degree, x degree equal to 180 minus 70, therefore this will gives 110 degree is your answer. Next question is again from the quadrilateral 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the pentagon. Irregular pentagon is given. Irregular means that there is no matching with the side. Just first I have to draw the figure is in this way. If one angle is a 90 degree, then other angle will be the also 90 degree. We know that. Here exterior angle is a 70 degree. This is a x degree and here it is a perpendicular also 90 degree. This is the sine of the perpendicular 90 degree and this is a 60 degree. Here everything is given here that this is the 90 degree, sine of the 90 degree is given, therefore you can put 90 degree here, 90 degree sine is given that you can put the 90 degree. And this angle plus this angle forming the linear pair, therefore 70 degree plus 110 degree equal to 180 degree, 180 minus 70, 110, this is 110. This is x degree and it is not given that. And here this will be how much? How much this will be? 60 degree plus 60 degree plus this will be 120 degree. And now everything is here mentioned and you can find out the value of x. And we know that the value of exterior angle equal to 360 degree, whether that is of any gon, means pentagon, hexagon, octagon, nonagon. This is a 90 degree. So this angle is a 90 degree, 90 degree, 70 degree, x degree, 90 degree and a 60 degree makes together 360 degree. So therefore, we know that sum of exterior angle of polygon 360 degree, therefore x degree plus 90 degree plus 60 degree plus 90 degree plus 70 degree equal to 360 degree. Now, on combining x degree plus 180 plus 60 plus 70 equal to 360 degree. Now, here x degree plus 240 degree plus 70 degree equal to 360 degree. Now x degree plus 310 degree equal to 360 degree. And x degree equal to 360 degree minus 310 degree equal to 50 degree is your answer. After that, there are lots of the trapezium related to the trapezium sums are given. And I would like to solve the given examples as well as the exercise problem also. Next, just we are going to explain the related to the quadrilateral sums based on the quadrilateral problems based on the quadrilateral. Problem based on problems based on regular polygon. Regular polygon. Here, in a sum that given that a parallelogram number one, that a parallelogram is given, a parallelogram is given, and about the parallelograms I have explained each and every properties of the parallelograms in the lecture number second and third respectively. So you will not find any problem to solve related based on the regular polygon. Here this is the parallelogram, and already I have explained that in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal and parallel each other. Here the question is given that P, Q, R, here in the question you have P, Q, Q, P, Q, R, P, Q, R, and this is the S is given. Then SR means shorter side, width of the parallelogram is given that this is a 7 cm. And the requirement is find the perimeter. I have explained the formula to find the perimeter. Means twice perimeter of parallelogram equal to twice L plus B unit. Okay, I have written this, and also given the relationship, the given that this is a 12 cm, and this is a breadth and this is the length, and opposite sides are equal, this will be also 7 cm, this will be also the 12 cm. You can find the value of the perimeter of this parallelogram by using the formula, this twice L plus B. 2, you will put L is a 12 and breadth is a 7, therefore 2 into 12 plus 7, this is the 19, 92 is a 38, and unit is a centimeter, therefore you will write the centimeter. This is the based on the parallelogram. Next sum is also based on the parallelogram related to the angle. And I have also explained the what is the relationship in the parallelogram between the angles. Sum of the adjacent angle 180 degree, opposite angles are equal. You will again see again and again the video of the lecture number 2nd and 3rd. You will find that every properties related to the quadrilaterals I have explained, and a few formulas I have given in the lecture number 4 also. So you will see, and required to see again and again the classes, and you will find no problem. And when you will sit to solve the exercise, and you will get yourself easy to solve them. So please see again and again, and all the problems will be sort out themselves. Okay. Now a quadrilateral is given that this is a quadrilateral. In this way, a quadrilateral is given that means parallelogram is given. This is the parallelogram. Parallelogram is also quadrilateral. So whether you can say quadrilateral or parallelogram, somewhat different, since it is also made of the four sides. Therefore, you can quadrilateral, and it is a regular. There is a certain relationship. That's why it is said to be the parallelogram. A, B, C, D. Now angle B is given that 100 degree. Angle this C is Z, and exterior angle is a Y, and this is the X, and this is not required to find. Find the value of X, Y, Z. And all you know that this is the parallelogram. Opposite sides of the sides of a parallelograms are parallel. Since AD and BC are the parallel side, therefore this side CD act as the transversal. Again, this is parallel to this parallel, and this act as a transversal. Therefore, this angle plus this angle equal to 180 degree, or sum of adjacent angle. I have written on the blackboard sum of adjacent angles in a parallelogram equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 100 degree plus angle Z degree equal to 180 degree. Angle Z equal to 180 degree minus 100 degree. Therefore, this will be the 80 degree. Now, already you have found that this is 80 degree. And again, I have explained in the lecture number 2. That sum of adjacent angle is 180 degree, this plus this, and opposite angles of the parallelogram is equal. Since this angle and this angle is opposite angle, therefore you can say that x equal to 100 degree also. And now the term is y equal to 180 degree minus 80 degree. This will be also 100 degree, because this angle plus this angle making the linear pair. Therefore, there is no problem to find out. Okay. Next, sum is in parallelogram. Parallelogram, all the angles you can find if one angle is given that. Now diagonal of the parallelogram, about the diagonal of the parallelograms, I have explained that diagonals of the parallelograms are unequal, not equal. They bisect each other at any angles, means there is no relationship between the angle, but bisect each other. So any of the diagonal and other part of the diagonal is given that, therefore you can say that diagonals are congruent triangles. You also show that congruent triangles forming is in the parallelogram, where two diagonals are intersecting there. If diagonals are given, then you can find the other diagonals also. One sum I am going to explain related to the diagonals of the parallelogram. Related to the diagonals of a parallelogram. A parallelogram here given PQRS. P H E and L. L is given and this is the one of the diagonal and this is the second diagonal. This is O, this equal to this and this part equal to this part. And this is the point of intersection. O is the point of intersection. In the given figure, help. Help is a figure HELP. Help, what is it? Means HELP is a parallelogram. Help a parallelogram. This is a parallelogram. And given that OE equal to OE, this part is given that 4 centimeter. Therefore, this will be also 4 centimeter. 4 centimeter. Because bisect, HL bisect PE. Already know that. And HL is a 5 more than PE. So therefore, this will be HL HL equal to PE, value of PE plus 5 more. Therefore, PE can be written OE plus PO plus 5E. This can be splitted. OE, the value of OE is given 4 centimeter and PO will be also 4 centimeter because bisect the 4 centimeter and this will be the 5 centimeter more, the 5 centimeter you must have to add them. 4, 8 plus 5, this will give 13 centimeter. Therefore, HL equal to 13 centimeter. And OH, if you are required to find the OH, the OH will be the half bisect, means 6.5 centimeter will be there. In the next lecture number 6 and 7 will be also there. In the lecture 6, I will explain the exercise number 3.3 and 3.4 will be explained, and you will take benefit from the next lectures, and next lecture will be soon available on your Yulo app, and you will have to remain continue with the app and see again and again. And next day I will deliver the speech exercise number 3.3 and 3.4. Okay, students, thank you.